This video illustrates the use of Venn diagrams for certain kinds of counting situations. First, a bit of notation. For any set, let's say capital A, when we want to designate the number of elements in the set, a shorthand way of doing that is to use functional notation n of A. So think of n of A for any set A as just representing the number of elements that belong to that set. For example, if capital A is the set shown here, it has the four elements A, B, C, and D. So n of A, the number of elements of A, is equal to 4. An important basic fact about the number of elements in sets is when you're looking at a union of two sets, the number of elements in the union is the number in the one plus the number in the other minus the number in the intersection. It's fairly easy to see why that's true. When we're looking at the union, we're looking at everything inside either of the two circles A and B. If we count the number of elements in A, we've counted everybody in here. If we count the number of elements of B, we've counted everybody inside the B circle. And in doing so, we've counted the folks that lie in the intersection of the two twice, which is why we have to subtract off the intersection one time to make things balance. To illustrate, if A contains these four elements and B these four elements, then the union of A and B has the six elements, A, B, C, D, E, and F, so the number of elements in the union is 6, and 6 is equal to the number of elements in A, which is 4, plus the number of elements of B, which is also 4, minus the number of elements in the intersection, which is 2, since the intersection of the two sets consists just of the elements C and D. So when we do 4 plus 4 minus 2, we've counted A, we've counted B, and then we're subtracting off the number in the overlap of the two sets. There's a similar formula like this that's valid for the union of three sets. It's a bit more complicated, and one of your WebAssign exercises illustrates what that formula looks like and also illustrates why it's true. For our next example, let's move to a deck of cards. An ordinary deck of playing cards has 52 cards. There are four different suits, clubs, diamonds, hearts, and spades, having 13 cards each. The two sets of cards we're going to be thinking about in this example are the hearts and the kings. We'll denote the hearts in the deck simply by a red heart symbol. And we'll denote the kings by the green letter K. How many cards belong to the union of these two sets? Well, there are 13 hearts in the deck, so n of that set, the number of elements of that set, is 13. The number of kings is equal to 4, so the number of elements of that set is 4, since there are 4 kings in the deck, the king of clubs, of diamonds, of hearts, and of spades. How many cards are there in the overlap of these two sets? How many cards are there which are both a heart and a king? There's only one. It's the king of hearts. So the number of elements in the intersection is 1. According to the formula, the number of elements in the union should be the number of hearts plus the number of kings minus the number in the intersection, which would be 16. See if you can convince yourself that that answer is correct. Let's try to use a Venn diagram to do the bookkeeping in this question here. A college has 700 students, and we have data on the breakdown of the students, how many of them study each of three languages, how many study various combinations of languages, and then we have a series of questions that are asked. The strategy in approaching a question like this is to begin by putting all the information into a Venn diagram, and then after you have your Venn diagram correctly constructed, you should be able to answer any question that you're asked. So we want to construct our Venn diagram so that it accurately reflects all this information. Depending on the order in which the information is presented, you may have to give some thought to what order you fill in the numbers and the regions in the Venn diagram. With this particular flow of information, it's easiest to work our way from the inside out. So we're going to start by looking at this last piece of information, 6 read all 3 languages, and use that to put a 6 in that region that represents the overlap of the 3 groups, the ones who study French, who study German, and who study Spanish. Now, as we work our way back up, we have 14 who read German and Spanish. The overlap of the German and Spanish groups would be this football-shaped region here. We've already located 6 of the people in that area, so for the total to be 14 who study German and Spanish, that means we have to put an 8 as illustrated in, by the red 8 right here. So we have 6, let's, for consistency, check that we now have 6 reading all 3 languages, and we now have 14 reading German and Spanish. Working our way back up, 22 read French and Spanish. So for consistency, that means we need to put a 16 in this spot. That gives us a total of 22 in the overlap of the French group and the Spanish group. 30 read French and German. Means we have to put a 24 in this spot. That gives us a total of 30 reading French and German. 175 read Spanish, so that's going to be the total inside the S circle, so we have to put a number right here, which makes that total be exactly 175. We can determine what that requires by subtraction, and we find that we have to put 145 in this spot. To make the total for German be 100, we need to put a 62 in this spot. And finally, to make the total for French be 200, we need a 154 right here. How many students read exactly 2 of the 3 languages? That would include the students who read French and Spanish, but not German. These 16. It would include these 24 who read French and German but not Spanish, and it would include these 8 who read German and Spanish but not French. So we add those 3 numbers together and we get a total of 48 students who read exactly 2 of the 3 languages. How many students read at least 1 of the 3 languages? Well, that would include everybody who's in any of the 3 circles, wouldn't it? The total of all those numbers adds up to 415. How many students read exactly 1 of the 3 languages? That would be the ones who read French, but neither German or Spanish, and the ones who read only German, and the ones who read only Spanish. Those 3 totals add up to 361. How many students don't read any of the 3 languages? Well, this is where we need to bring into play the final piece of information we haven't yet made use of, that is that the college has 700 students. We had already accounted for all of those who studied at least 1 of the languages. For the total to be 700, we can simply subtract all of these numbers from 700 to find that there must be 285 in this group outside of the 3 circles, which means the students who don't study any of the 3 languages, total of 285. A company's making cookies, 100 types of cookies. Some of the types require vanilla. Some require chocolate, some require nuts, some require vanilla and nuts, some require chocolate and nuts, Some require vanilla and chocolate. We're going to let V be the set of all the types of cookies that require vanilla, C, all the types that require chocolate, and N, all the type that require nuts. And then we have three questions, three counting questions we want to answer. You might start by putting all this information into a Venn diagram, a V circle for the vanilla types, the types that require vanilla, a C circle for the types that require chocolate, an N circle for the types that require nuts. If you fill in all the information that we have been given into the Venn diagram, your Venn diagram should look as shown here. So pause the movie, go back and check all that data, and make sure that you agree that it's consistent with the Venn diagram which we're looking at now. The first question asks, how many of the types of cookies require either chocolate or vanilla? Which is simply asking, how many elements are there in the set C union V? From the Venn diagram, we can get that by simply adding up all the numbers that lie in the union of the V and C circles, the numbers that are shown in red in the picture here. If you want to think about it in terms of the counting formula that we looked at earlier, you can think of that total as simply being the number that require chocolate, which is the 39 inside the C circle, plus the number that require vanilla, the sum of these four totals, minus the number in the overlap, which is the 20, 13 plus 7 is 20, that require both chocolate and vanilla. So it's not necessary to use the counting formula, but we can look at the counting formula and illustrate an alternate way of arriving at the grand total. The number of elements of this set, let's try to say this in words. Looking at the number of elements in the set consisting of all the types of cookies that require either they require vanilla or else they don't require nuts, and they also don't require chocolate. It's kind of a tongue twister to try to say that. Let's try to convince ourselves that the number of elements in this set is obtained by adding up the three red numbers in the picture. See, what we're looking at is V union N complement. So take everything in V and include everything not in N. If you take everything in V and stick in everything that's not in N, then that also throws in this 7 and this 2. So looking at this union, you've got all the numbers that are either red or green in this picture. But then when we intersect with C complement, that says we have to throw away everything that's not in C, which is the three green numbers, which are in C. So what we're left with when we throw away the three green numbers is just these three red numbers, whose sum is 45, which is the answer to this part of the question. Next question. Can we put this into words? We're looking at the cookies that don't require either chocolate or vanilla. C union V would be the ones that require either chocolate or vanilla. So when we look at the complement of that, it's the cookies that don't require either of those, or else, that is union, they require nuts. So let's try to convince ourselves that this total is 74. Where do I get a 74 for that? Well, let's start by looking at C union V. C union V is everything inside the V or the C circles combined. So it's everything, it's those six groups. The complement of that then would be the groups that are outside of both the C and the V circle. So it would be these 16 types of cookies plus these two types of cookies. But what we're looking at is the union of those types with the types that do require nuts, which is all the types inside the n circle. So when we include with the two groups represented by the green numbers everything inside the n circle, that means we pick up in addition these three groups right here. So all the types of cookies that meet this condition would be the groups represented by the green numbers plus the groups represented by the red numbers. And if you add up the 31, the 13, the 12, the 16, and the 2, you have a total of 74 types of cookies corresponding to the set which we're trying to count in part C here.